Hello and welcome back to Pharma Info with Shubhashish. Now today we have decided to deal with a particular drug which is given to the patient who is suffering from COPD, asthma, right? Okay. It is often been found in the preparation of inhaler, right? Okay. So that is nothing but ipratropium bromide, right? So ipratropium bromide is an example of an anticholinergic, right? We all know that it is the cholinergic receptors. They can cause some bronchoconstriction, right? They can cause. So definitely antagonizing the cholinergic receptor, cholinergic stimulation eventually leads to the expansion of bronchial airways, and which is found to be beneficial for the patient who is suffering from asthma, right? So it can be given to the patient who is suffering from asthma, okay? So asthmatic exacerbation, right? Okay, can be treated with ipratropium bromide, right? And sometimes along with certain drugs, this can be given and which already has shown a synergistic effect and all, right? Okay. So we'll not go to that particular aspect, rather we'll just see that how it can be made and all. The synthesis is found to be very easy, right? But the thing is, the structure is found to be somewhat tricky at the initial stage, right? So ipratropium bromide, okay, so it's a derivative or congener of what? Atropine. So atropine, how it looks? So atropine is found to be something like this, right? So we have a O, then C double bond O, then CH, then CH2OH, then a phenyl, that is a part of tropic acid. It is the tropic acid and tropane. It is the tropic acid and tropene. Sorry, not tropane, tropene. If I say tropane, means I have to mention 3-hydroxytropane, right? But tropane includes the hydroxyl at this particular position, because after all, it is the hydroxyl of tropene. It is the hydroxyl of tropene reacts with the OH of what? OH of tropic acid. And finally, on removal of a single molecule of water, merging took place, and you are just observing the particular thing as it is, right? Chalo. But the additional thing that is there in atropine is found to be a methyl, right? Okay. So ipratropium bromide. Ipra, that means isopropyl. So additional thing is, we have an isopropyl, or we can say sometimes propan-2-yl, right? So propan-2-yl bromide, right? So this is how it looks, ipratropium bromide. Now this is a bicyclic system, right? If you have gone through my videos, right, I have already made a video on bicyclic system nomenclature, right? Please go through it if you are not thorough with the naming of bicyclic system, right? Okay. So how the nomenclature goes? Okay. How the nomenclature goes? So can we say this is an ester? Can we say this is a propanoate? Can we say this is a propanoate? Right? Propanoate, right? Okay. And the same propanoate is holding what? The major substituent, right? And few minor substituents, right? Okay. So this is what hydroxyl placed at 1, 2, 3, third position. So we have 3 hydroxyl. At second position, we have another substituent that is found to be phenyl. So 2 phenyl. Okay. ये तो मतलब last में. Okay. पहले हमको जो लिखना है, इस हिस्से को पहले निपटाना है, ठीक? First we'll just deal with this, wrap it up, and then we'll move to this particular small substituents, right? Okay. So as it's a bicyclic system, these two are found to be the bridgeheads, right? As it is a bridgeheads, so that means we have to start the numbering from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? Okay. So basically this bicyclic system comprised of 8 essential elements, right? So that is why, can we say it's a octane? It's an octane, right? So it's an octane basically. So it's an octane, right? Okay. So basically it's an octane, and definitely octan-3-yl. Why? Because third position it is acting as a substituent. The entire thing is acting as a substituent. Why? Because just now we have considered this as a parent, not this as a parent. And that is why octan a octan 3-aryl, this is the position, okay, which is connected to this oxygen, and oxygen is further connected to the C double bond to form the weight, that is ester, right? Okay, so it is the 8 that is holding what? 8 methyl, 8 propan, 1 2 3 1 2 3 2, propan 2-aryl over 10. Amongst this 8 key members of this bicyclic system, one heteroatom is there. We need to mention that one, 8 azonia, 8 you can say also azania, azania. Then bicyclo, system is bicyclic system, so it's a bicyclo. Then we have to count what? We have to count the number of components which constitute each and every branch. We have one branch, we have another branch, and we have another branch. Got my point? Okay. And here we have to follow from big to, from high to low. That means if it is 3 to 1, we should not say 1, 2, 3. It is 3 to 1 because it should follow a descending order. But in case of spiral system, you have to follow the ascending order, small to big, right? Okay. So here, how many members are there? This is the major branch. Major branch comprised of how many members? 1, 2, 3. 3 are there. So in a third bracket, you have to put 3. Then this is the secondary, another branch. 1, 2. Put 2 here. And this is the third branch comprised of one element, right? One element. So likewise, 3 to 1. So what I told initially, 8 methyl, 8 propan, 2-aryl. Then bicyclo or 8 azania. We have to mention the heteroatom present in the bicyclic system, 8 azania. Then bicyclo, then 3 to 1, then octan, then 3-aryl. Close the bracket. And after that, we are left with what? It's a propanoate basically. So it is 3 hydroxy, 2 phenyl, propanoate. That's all. Propanoate, bromide. That's all. So this is the way ipratropium bromide can be named, right? Okay. So what synthetic strategy can be adopted here? So here basically, we'll just methylate what? We'll just methylate noratropium. Chalega? Okay, let us just remove it. Okay. Let us just remove it for the time being. I wish to methylate noratropium or derivatized noratropium. Chalega ye name? Dekhte hum log. As I told at the initial stage that the naming is found to be big. Okay? Found to be big. Somewhat complicated. Once you know the tricks, then it will become a cakewalk for you, right? But the synthesis is found to be very short, one-step synthesis. What I told that suppose ki the starting material should be straightway, because we have this is available to us. CH2OH phenyl, and then we'll put nitrogen here. Suppose ki I'm putting here hydrogen, can we still call it as atropine? No, we should call it as noratropine. Okay, but at this area I'm just trying to put the other substituent, that is prop2-aryl. So can we say now N prop2-aryl, then overall thing is noratropine. So basically this is N or 8, okay, N prop2-aryl, then noratropine, one of the starting material. So what I need to do here, just I need to methylate, alkylate noratropine into atropine and convert this to ipratropium bromide. So basically bring methyl bromide. So methyl bromide, what this will do? This will replace the hydrogen, get itself inserted here, and finally leaving behind. So here we have a positive charge and here we have minus charge. So with that, we are done with the making of what? Ipratropium bromide, given to the patient who is suffering from asthma, COPD, right? Especially meant for bronchodilation, right? Thank you so very much. So hope you have enjoyed the session. It's a small session, right? Okay, I'm not used to it, right? Okay, so please, if you enjoyed the session, don't forget to press the like button. And moreover, please do subscribe my channel. At the same time, put your comments, valuable comments, unbiased comments, right? So that I can grow, I can improve myself, right? Thank you so very much. Thank you for your patience. Thank you.